You saw something in me when no one else did. I was just this invisible guy in the corner, and I thought I liked being that way. Then I met you, and I figured out I'm actually good at something.
Oh. You're a complete moron!
No, I'm not.
That was a rhetorical question.
Don't go. Just
trying to help. Don't. Great, it's you.
I get it. You're mean.
I heard she bit Simon Furthassel on the skirt. And now it's all wonky, like a discount avocado.
It's definitely not true.
Do you want one?
I just think I'm gonna die now.
Don't worry about it. Speaking as a long-time member of the Moordale Social Pariah Club, you'll survive. The students at the school need your help, Otis. And we need their money. I haven't really worked out the details yet, but I'm good with numbers, so I'll deal with the business end of things, and you can do the therapy. We'll charge for every appointment and split the cash.
Therapy?
Yeah, sex therapy. Look, I haven't got all day. Are you in or out? Okay, fine. Don't worry about it.
Man, are you really saying you don't want to hang out with Maeve Wiley?
But she's not popular. She's scary. Yeah,
exactly. She's better than popular because she's cool.
Wait. I'm in. I might have a mild to moderate crush on Maeve. She touched my eyebrows. Now I have an erection.
I need to meet me somewhere after school at 6:30.
Why are we in an abortion clinic?
She also needs someone to take her home.
Hi.
You waited?
Of course.
Do you want a sandwich?
You're so weird, Otis. Those flowers for me.
Maeve and I were, you know...
Boning.
Yeah, and it's great. But I've sort of realised that I want her to hang around with me more.
How's it going with Jackson?
What do you mean?
I mean, you guys seem to be spending a lot of time together.
Anyway, I don't do boyfriends.
Will you please be my girlfriend? Well, that was unexpected.
But love isn't about grand gestures or the moon and the stars. It's just dumb luck. And sometimes you meet someone who feels the same way. And then sometimes you're unlucky. But one day you're gonna meet someone who appreciates you for who you are. I mean, there's 7 billion people on the planet. I know one of them is gonna climb up on a moon for you.
Should have seen the smug look Ola gave me earlier. Don't like her.
Why? She seems nice.
She's still hung up on Otis.
It's got nothing to do with Otis. I'm over him.
I miss you.
I better get to class. I messed it up with you. There was this moment last term where I thought maybe you liked me. And I liked you back.
Why are you telling me this now?
Why'd you look angry?
Because, Maeve, you can't... That's not fair. I liked you. I really liked you. I fucking turned myself inside out liking you.
You did like me.
Yes. Of course I did. And now you're saying you felt the same?
Yeah, I was confused.
I have a girlfriend. I
made myself get over you, Maeve, and now everything's fine. Everything's normal. Everything's great.
I like Maeve. I like Maeve a lot. Like, a lot more than I liked Ola. And then, Ola dumped me. Yeah, it's confusing. I was confused. But I thought, probably a good thing, because I just really wanted to be with Maeve. And I didn't really want to be with Ola. I think she's probably the most selfish person I've ever met.
You telling me you had feelings for me was... was all I wanted to hear, and I was so caught up in trying to do the right thing, I lost track of what that actually is. And it's you.
It's always been you. I love you, Maeve.
Message deleted.
Ruby Matthews is secretly shagging Otis Milburn.
You and Ruby are a thing.
Well, we're not anymore. We were for a bit, but it was casual, you know.
Why did you and Ruby break up?
I didn't like her as much as she liked me.
It's true. I know.
What about you? How's it going with that Isaac guy?
That Isaac guy? Yeah, things are good. I like him. I know he left me a voicemail.
Can we not talk about that? It's embarrassing enough you've ignored me for months. Or just pretend it didn't happen.
I never got it. Isaac deleted it.
What do you mean, deleted?
He was trying to protect me, apparently. He fucked up. It's a whole thing. Otis, you acted like a complete dick to me last term. You don't get let off the hook just because you call up once and say I'm sorry.
That's exactly how apologies work, Maeve.
You shouldn't have deleted it.
No, you shouldn't have. But he did. And here we are. Did you mean it?
Of course I meant it.
Scheme thing. To study in America for a couple months. They booked me on a flight tomorrow, but I'm not going.
Why?
Because things are good with Otis. I don't want to mess it up again.
If I was going to miss out on an opportunity for a boy, what would you tell me?
I'd probably tell you to screw your head back on.
Exactly.
Okay, I've changed my mind.
About what?
America. I found the money, so I'm going.
Right. Proud of you. I mean it. So this is goodbye?
No. No. It's see you soon.
So I was texting Maeve. And she sent me a nude.
What? Egg cake! Oh my god, that's huge!
I haven't responded yet.
Are you mad?
Stop yelling!
No, Otis, you have to send one back. There's a sexting etiquette. You can't just leave her hanging.
Okay, I know. I took a load of pictures. And I just didn't send any. I hated them.
I'm sorry, I didn't handle it well. And I should have texted.
I think I'm scared to make myself vulnerable.
When I don't know that you're coming back.
Why wouldn't I be coming back?
I mean, it sounds like you're having a really great time over there.
Oh, I am.
But it's also hard being away from home.
And I miss you. A lot.
Yeah, I miss you too.
I have something to tell you, actually.
You know my teacher, Mr. Malloy? He's looking for an intern. I think I've got a chance of getting it.
And staying in America?
Yeah, I guess so. Forgot the position.
Right. Well, that's a big deal.
Why are you being weird?
Because you said you were definitely coming back.
Well, I might have changed my mind.
Okay, I've got to go.
What? For someone who's supposed to be emotionally intelligent, you could be such an
immature asshole sometimes, Otis.
Maeve, I'm really sorry. We fought and I said some
stupid things and I should have been more supportive. You're right, I was
Otis,
being...
It doesn't matter. I'm going to the airport.
My mum's in hospital. She's had an overdose.
It's serious.
What?
Coming home.
I see.
Don't go, actually. Please.
I am very sorry to inform you that your mother has passed away.
We're here for you.
Whatever you need. Yeah, we should probably head back and tell Anna.
Hey, I wanted to tell you something.
Okay. Is it going to be a buzzkill? Because I've had a really terrible day and I really want us to have some fun tonight.
Ta-da! I got you flowers. I don't really know if this was too much. Maybe it is, but I kept changing my mind.
I spent the night with Ruby. I had to tell you. It's when you were in America, we were fighting and We slept together and...
No, as in, we didn't have sex. Like, nothing happened. We just stayed in the same bed. Sorry.
I know I fucked up. Okay, I am really sorry. I think I was just missing you a lot and I wanted to feel important, which is pathetic. And I'd hate for this to be the reason that things don't work out with us.
Nothing happened?
No.
Don't want me home. I think I'm going back to America. I don't want to lose you, Otis.
Are you saying you don't know if you'd come back?
We could still make it work, though.
I think we both know that. But it would be too hard.
I love you.
I love you.
Dear Otis, you know I hate soppy romantic stuff, so don't get your hopes up. This isn't a love letter. When we first met, I didn't trust anyone. I thought that if I kept everybody out, I'd stop myself from being hurt or let down, which is what I was used to. Then we set the clinic up together, and I realized that most of the people who came to us for help really just needed connection. And maybe I wasn't so different. You have the rare ability to make people feel truly seen, and you did the same for me. It was this and your relentless optimism about human beings that gave me the courage to start opening myself up to other people. For the first time in my life, I didn't feel alone, which allowed me to imagine something bigger for myself. And I want you to know that however much it fucking hurts that we can't be together, I won't ever close myself off again. Meeting you cracked my heart open, and now it's forever changed. And because of that, I will carry part of you with me wherever I go. I think what I'm trying to say is, thanks for everything. Dickhead.